Hello guys, I am here with the concluding video of lesson 4A, that is why lesson 4B. We just go through that lesson 4A from and then after that you will be watching this particular video, lesson 4B. There we were talking about the recognition of any relation from A to B when A and B contains large number of elements. Naturally, when A and B contains large number of elements, it is quite a tedious job to find to write A cross B. I don't say that this is not possible to write A cross B. It is possible, but it would be time consuming to write A cross B in details. In that case, how will you recognize whether the given or the considered set is a relation from A to B or A to A or not? For that, I just try to make you understand with the help of some examples. Just watch over here. Suppose A contains these 10 elements. 1 to 10 I have written, 10 natural numbers, and B contains all English alphabets, that means A to Z. A has 10 elements, B has got 26 elements. Naturally, A cross B will have 26, 10 are 260 elements, and it is quite a tedious job to write all those 260 pairs at a time on the notebook. In fact, no need to write that A cross B to deal with the given set whether it is a relation from A to B or A to A or not. Suppose we have considered four. We just want to see whether they are relations from A to B or A to A or B to B or not. For that, what is to be checked out? Just go on watching carefully the elements of the given set. We start right from R1. Just go on watching the elements. 3 elements is being contained by R1. 4 elements are there in R2. Again, 3 elements in R3, 3 elements in R4, and 3 elements in R5. Okay, so just see the first components of the elements of R1, 1, 2, and 3. Do 1, 2, and 3 lie in A? Yes, they lie in A. What about the second component, A, Y, and D? Yes, A, Y, D are the elements of B. Naturally, R1 is a subset of A cross B. So this is the only way to recognize whether given set is a subset of A cross B or not. Just go on watching the first component as well as the second component. Likewise, for R2, just go on watching 1, 5, 2, and 9 as a first component. They are in A. Again, 3, 7, 1, and 4, they are also in A. Naturally, R2 is what? A subset of A cross A. So R2 is a relation on A, whereas R1 is a relation from A to B. Now what about R3? Just one watching. AA, BC and YX. The first component A, B and Y, as well as second component A, C and X. All of them are from the set B. Naturally, R3 is a subset of what? B cross B. So R3 is a relation over the set B. These two are binary relations, the second one and third one. What about R4? You just go on watching the elements of R4, the components 2, 3 and 9. They are belonging to A. What about A, Z and 10? A, Z are the elements of B, but 10 is not an element of B. That is why we say that R4 is not a subset of A cross B, and hence R4 is not a relation from A to B. What about R5? Again, watch the first component 5, 9 and 0. 5 and 9 are the elements of A, but 0 is not any element of A, whereas the second components are from A. But since 0 is not lying in A, so on that basis we can say that R5 is not a subset of A cross A. When we will be forming A cross A, we won't get what is that appear like this 0, 5, because 0 is not an element of A. So first 3 are relations either from A to B or A to A or B to B, but the last two, 4, R4 and R5, are not relations from A to B or A to A or B to B. So this is the only way to recognize whether the given set is a relation from A to B or A to A or not without writing A cross B. So very simple way to represent this one. Now, after this, I am going to deal with the number of relations. How many relations can we obtain from A to B or A to A? That is the main thing we are going to discuss about. when we are going to find the number of relations from A to B or A to A, you just think seriously or patiently. You will be finding that the number of relation is already hidden in the definition of the relation. What did we say about the definition of relation? That any subset of A cross B is a relation from A to B. That means what? All those subsets of A cross B are relation from A to B. And how many subsets of A cross B can we have? In the previous classes, we have already done the 2 raised to the power number of elements in A cross B. So as many subsets of A cross B or A cross A are there, the same number of relations can be established from A to B or A to A. I just clarify it with an example. Suppose here number of elements in A is equal to 2 and number of elements in B is equal to 3. This implies number of elements in A cross B is equal to NA into NB, that is equal to what? 2 into 3 equal to 6, right? Also, number of elements N of A cross A is equal to 4, N of B cross B equal to 9. Now, number of relations from first A to B is equal to what? The number of subsets of A cross B. Number of subsets of A cross B. That is 2 raised to the power n of A cross B, which equals 2 to the power 6, that is 64. And number of relations from A to A is equal to 2 to the power 2, that is 4. And number of relations from B to B is what? 2 raised to the power. How much? 3 elements are there, the 2 to the power 3 into 3, that is 2 to the power 9, that is 5, 1, 2. A to A is 2 to the power 4, that is 16. Number of elements in A into number of elements in A, that is 2 to the power 4, that is 16. So from A to B, we shall have 64 relations. From A to B, we shall have 16. And from B to B, we shall have 512 relations to be defined. So this is all about the number of relations from A to B and A to A. In lesson 5, we have already dealt with the domain, codomain and range of relation. Just watch over there. And then after watching the lesson 5, we shall be dealing with the types of relation. Thank you.